Good afternoon, students. In today's class, we are going to start the next topic in distributed file system, that is coordination and agreement. This is the second part of the unit number 5. This is the mainly discusses with coordination and agreements. The contents to be discussed in this unit are introduction about the coordination. What is distributed mutual exclusion, elections, coordination management, and consensus and related problems. Yeah, coming to the introduction about coordination and agreement. This is related to process. Okay, how processes will coordinate their actions. Here, our main assumption in coordination is each pair of processes is connected by reliable channels, and processes are independent from each other. One process is independent from other process. Here, the processes fails with only one reason, because of processes crashing. That is the only reason the processes will be failed. Next, distributed mutual exclusion. Next topic is distributed mutual exclusion. See here, the distributed processes are require a mechanism that can coordinate their activities because they share resources or the collection of resources. Here, mutual exclusion means if more than one process wants to execute on the same resource, same time, that is said to be the mutual exclusion. Here, the mutual exclusion is required to prevent the interference. Why? Because they are accessing the same resources. Two or more processes are accessing the same resources, then there might be a possibility of interference. Why? Because one process may update the data and another process may add the data, another process will delete the data, like that. Okay, here the mutual exclusion is required to prevent interference and ensure the consistency when accessing the resources. We need to have the consistency. That means if any process wants to do the operation, just it will make a copy of the data and do operations on the copied data. The resource should be consistent enough. Here, see, this is a shared resource. These shared resources among several processes, process 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, N number of processes are sharing this resource. So this situation is called as mutual exclusion situation. This mutual exclusion is required to prevent the interference. That means one process need not to be interfered with another process and ensure the consistency. Suppose the process 1 updates the data, that should not affect with the process 2. Why? Because if process 1 wants to update any information in the shared resource, the process 1 makes a copy of data and do operations, do updates, do whatever the operation they want to do on the copy of data. Here, the algorithms for mutual exclusion is, first, the requirements for mutual exclusion are safety. At most, one process may execute in the critical section. Already, we discussed in operating systems, critical section problem, Peterson solution. Only at most one process may execute in the critical section at a time. If a process wants to execute, it must enter into the critical section. That is what they have mentioned here. Safety is nothing but at most one process may execute in the critical section, that is CS, at a time. Second requirement is liveness. Request to enter and exit the critical section eventually succeeded. Here, the entering into the critical section and exit from the critical section eventually succeed. Next, ordering. If one request to enter the CS critical section happened before another, then entry to the CS is granted in the order. That means the process which requested to enter into the critical section requested first will enter into the critical section requested first. So they enter into the critical section first. Why? Because here the ordering is maintained. Here the criteria for distribution, the criteria is the bandwidth is consumed when proportional to the number of messages sent in each entry and exit operation. See here, for each entry and exiting of processes to enter in and out of critical section, it will consume the bandwidth and the client delay incurred by a process at each entry and exit. Why? Because to entry and exit, the client may be delayed. The algorithm's effect upon the throughput of the system. Here, this will put impact on the throughput of the system. Here, some of the examples of algorithms are the central server algorithm, ring-based algorithm, multicast and logical clocks, and Mekawa's voting algorithm. These are the different type of distributed mutual exclusion algorithm. The first one is the central server algorithm. This central algorithm, server algorithm, employs a server that grants permission to enter into the critical section. Here the name itself is saying the central server. Here the central server plays a role of giving grants or permission to enter into the critical section. If any process wants to enter into the critical section, it need to take the permission. It need to request the central server. After granting the permission to the process, then only it can able to enter into the critical section. See here, the server managing a mutual exclusion token for a set of processes. Here we are having P1, P2, P3, P4, four processes. Here the request token, here process P1, process P2 and process P3. Here P1 from process P2, it requests the token and it releases the token and grant the token. That means here, see the meaning of three points. Process P2 is requesting the token. That means the process P2 wants to enter into the critical section. That means the next one, process P3 here, release token. Okay, here the process P3 already requested a token and the server granted a token after exiting the critical section. It needs to release the token. It needs to release the token. Next, here for P4, previously P4 has requested to enter into the critical section. For that reason, it requested for a token. For the requested, it is granted a token. Here, 2, 4, these are the, what is this? 2 and 4. Here, process P2 request is 2 and process P4 request. Previously, process P4 has requested to enter into the critical section. That request is mentioned, these 2 and 4. These are the queue of requests at the server. Here, the central server algorithm, the server grants the permission to enter the critical section. For that reason, the processes needs to request the token. After requesting the token, the server will, the requests are in the queue at the server. The ordering will be maintained at the server. Once the request has been considered, the server will release the token. The server will grant the token. Once the process completed the critical section, that is exiting the critical section, it needs to release the token which is given by the server. Second algorithm in distributed mutual exclusion is a ring-based algorithm. As shown, it is in the form of ring. Here we need to arrange the processes in a logical ring. That is, here we are having n number of processes, P0, P1, P3, P4, and so on, n. Here, a ring of processes transferring a mutual exclusion token. See here, first the process, the P4 is having the token. After P4, Pn is having. After P1, P2, the token is the token rotates in the form of a ring. That is the reason why the process which got the token that will able to enter into the critical section. The process which releases the ring, it will exit from the critical section. Here, that will be the ring-based, that is the reason why it is said to be a ring-based algorithm. The third algorithm is multicast and logical clocks. Multi-clock and multicast and logical clocks. Here, processes that require entry to a critical section, multicast a request message. That means the processes. Here, multicasting, I told you, unicast, broadcast, multicast. Here, the multicast is nothing but the group of processes. The processes that require to enter. Previously, I told you the single process. If any single process wants to enter into the critical section, in the first one, it needs to request the token. After granting the token, it needs to release the token. In the second one, it is then the ring logic. The processes needs to be arranged in a logical ring fashion. In the third one, the multicast one, the processes here, the multiple the processes that requires to enter into the critical section, multicast a request message and can enter into and enter it only when all other processes have replied to this message. All other processes have replied to this message. Why? Because all this multicast, all the processes needs to have synchronization. This synchronization is called as multicast synchronization. I will show you in the diagram. See here, P1, P2, and P3. Here, see the diagram. We are having three processes. Excuse me. We are having three processes in the diagram. See the try to understand the diagram. If anyone got idea, let me know. See here. The process P1. What they are saying, the processes that require to enter into the critical section, multicast a request message and can enter into the enter it only when all other processes have replied to this message. First, let's take a P1 process. It wants to enter into the critical section. It needs to give, see here, for P3, for P2, it needs to give the message. For P2, it needs to give the message to P3 and P1. And for P3, it needs to give for P1 and P2. That means all other processes needs to reply. This is called as multicast synchronization. Next one, Macaw's voting algorithm. In this algorithm, the processes needs to obtain a permission to enter from subset of their peers. The processes needs to obtain the permission to enter from subset of their peers as long as the subsets used by any two processes overlaps. See here, I'm repeating once again. The processes needs to obtain the permission to enter from subsets of their peers as long as the subsets used by any two processes overlap. Okay, first, not all of the peers, okay, some of the peers. We need to collect the sufficient codes to enter into the critical section. The name it is saying Markov's coding algorithm. For that reason, we need to collect the sufficient codes to enter into the critical section. Okay, for that, we are having elections. Next, we are going to discuss election. What is election? Here, in the election, after distributed mutual exclusion, our topic is election. Here, an algorithm for choosing unique process to play a particular role. Let us take an example. A process PI can be a participant, can be a non-participant. If it is a participant, it is engaged in some runoff election algorithm. If it is a non-participant, it is not currently engaged in any election. That means a process is a participant, it is the part of election. If a process is not, the process is a non-participant, is not currently engaged of any election. Here some of examples of election algorithms are a ring-based election algorithm, the Bully algorithm. See, a ring-based election algorithm. Why this election algorithm? To elect a single process known as coordinator. Coordinator is nothing but the process with the largest identifier. Here, to elect a single process known as coordinator. That means the process with the largest identifier. Here, the algorithm gives every process is marked as a non-participant in an election. Initially, every process is marked as non-participant in an election. Any process can begin an election by making itself as a participant, placing its identifier in the election message and sending it to the clockwise neighbor. Suppose initially it is a ring-based algorithms. All processes are arranged in a logical ring fashion. Initially, all processes are non-participant in the election. Any process can begin an election by making itself as a participant. It should place its identifier in an election message and forward that to the neighbor, which is in the clockwise direction. Next, when a process receives an election message, it compares the identifier in the message with its own. Okay, you in the previous point, what I told you, it sends a message which is containing an identifier. Okay, the received process will check the election message and it compares the identifier in the message with its own identifier. If the arrived identifier is greater, listen carefully students, if the received identifier is greater, then it forwards the message to its neighbor in the clockwise. If the arrived identifier is smaller and the receiver is not a participant, then it substitutes its own identifier in the message. It substitutes its own identifier in the election message, but it does not forward to message if it is already participant. If it is not a participant, it needs to forward the message. If it is a participant, it does not forward the message. okay, on forwarding an election message in any case, the process marks itself as a participant. Suppose any process forwards the election message, itself a participant. If does not, itself a participant. See here. These are the election was started by process 17. The election was started by process 17 here. The highest process identifier encountered so far is 24. See, after 17, the election message has to forwarded in the clockwise direction. Okay, so far, the highest process identifier encountered is 24. The participant processes are shown in the darker tint. The participant process is in the darker tint. That is, see here. In the ring-based election process, the election was started by process 17 and it forwards. The identifier is 17. That means if it compares, the received process compares an identifier. 17 is less than 24. So it replaces election in the election. This 24 process replaces the election message and placing its identifier 24, and forwards that to the next process. The identifier is 24 is greater than 1, so it is not a larger identifier, so it forwards. As here the forward message is containing still the identifier value is 24. Why? Because 24 is less than 1. So next it goes to the 28. Here the 28 identifier is greater than 24. Okay, this is what the ring-based election. In this diagram shows you the ring-based election is in progress. Here the election was started by the process 17. And the highest process identifier encountered so far is 24. After 24, the next highest one is 28. This is a ring-based algorithm. Next one is in the election, the Bully algorithm. Here in this algorithm, it allows the processes to crash during an election. It allows the processes to crash during an election, although it assumes the message delivery between process is reliable. It assumes that the system is synchronous. That means it uses the timeouts to detect the process failure. Here, in this algorithm, this election second algorithm, Bully's algorithm, three types of messages used in this algorithm. First one is an election message. The second one is an answer message. Third one is a coordinator message. Coming to the election message, it's sent to announce an election. An election message is sent to announce an election. Answer message is sent in response to the election message. After sending the election message, in a reply, an answer message is sent in response to the election message. Now, coordinator message. This is sent to announce the identity of the elected process. Okay. This coordinated message tells us announce the identity of the elected process. See, these are the election. This diagram shows you the election of coordinator 2. Coordinator process P2 after the failure of P4 and P3. This diagram shows you the election of coordinator P2 after the failure of P4 and P3. I will show you. At stage 1, P1 sends election message. See here, observe students. P1 sends election message. P2 sends answer message. Okay. Next, P1 sends a reluction message to P3, and P3 also sent an answer message to P1. Here, next, in the second stage, here the coordination P4 fails. See, here the coordination failure P4 fails. Next, in the second stage, P2 sends an election message to P3 and P2 sends an election message to P4. And here P4 does not send answer message to P2. Only here P3 sent an answer message to P2. Next, after timeout, P3 and P4 are failed. Here, eventually, at stage 4, the coordinator is P2, which elected a P1 as elected process. See here, in this diagram, simple, we are having four processes. At stage T1, P1 sends, if any, we have, in the previous slide, we have seen three types of messages: election message, answer message, coordinator message. Here, the election message is to start the election. The answer message is to give a reply to the election message. And the coordination message is to announce the elected process. Here, in the first stage, the process P1 sends the election message to P2 and P3. And both P3 and P2 gives a answer message to P1. Here, in the election, the P4 is not participated. In the stage 2, the P2 sent election message to P2, P3 and P4. Only P3 gives the answer message and P4 does not give any answer message. Okay, here, after timeout, eventually the P2 acts as a coordinator and announce the P1 as the elected process. P1 as elected process. This is called as Bully's election algorithm. See here, as of now, we have completed an introduction about this coordination and agreement. After that, we have seen the distributed mutual exclusion. After that, we have seen election. In the election, we have seen two algorithms. One is ring-based algorithm. After that, Bully's algorithm. Now the next one is coordination and an agreement. Here, in coordination and agreement, in group communication, here each group of processes must receive the copies of messages sent to the group. Here the group communication requires, coordination and agreement. Agreement is on the set of messages that is received on the delivery of ordering. Okay. Mainly this particular point will discuss the multicast communication of group. Here, remember students, group communication is nothing but the multicast communication. Okay. I told you so many times, for multicast example is WhatsApp. It is maintaining the group communication. It will mainly discuss the multicast communication of processes and processes whose membership is known. That is static groups. See here. First, we need to know the system. Its system contains a collection of processes which can communicate reliably over one-to-one channels. See, here the system contains a collection of processes which can communicate reliably over one-to-one channels. Okay. Here, processes. Processes are members of the groups. Processes are members of groups. May fail. In the first slide, I told you the process fails only by crashing. Okay. Here, the diagram shows two groups. One is closed group and open group. Okay. In the closed group, no outsiders will be allowed. In the open group, anyone can be permitted to share. Coming to the primitives of multicast communication, first, multicast of G, M. That is, it sends a message M to all members of the group. That is, multicast of G, M. Deliver M. That means, delivers the message M to the calling process. Calling process means nothing but the requested process. For the requested process, it delivers the message M to the calling process. Sender M. Here, the unique identifier of the process that send the message M. Group M. A unique identifier of the group to which the message M was sent. Okay? The sender M means unique identifier of the process that sent the message M. Group M, unique identifier of the group to which the message M was sent. Here, the algorithms, we have three algorithms for this coordination and agreement in group communication. That is basic multicast algorithm, reliable multicast algorithm, ordered multicast algorithm. First one is the basic multicast algorithm. Here, this will guarantee that a correct process will eventually deliver the message as long as the multicaster do not crash. What they are saying, the correct process will deliver the message as long as they do not crash. Here, the primitives for this is B underscore multicast, B underscore deliver. That means, basic multicast deliver. B means basic here. Implementation. Use reliable one-to-one communication. Unreliable. Acknowledgements may be dropped. Here, why it is said to be unreliable means acknowledgements may be dropped here. See here. Two, B multicast G, M. That means, basic multicast of G, M means for the group G, it sends the message to the group of users. For each process P belongs to G, for each process belongs to the group G, we need to send P, M. Send P, M. P is the process message. That means the calling process will get the message. On receiving of message at process P, B deliver M at P. Okay, here this is the meaning of basic multicast algorithm. Second one is reliable multicast. Here the properties to satisfy in the reliable multicast is integrity. A correct process P delivers the message M at most once. Correct process P delivers the message M at most once. The validity comes to the validity. If a correct process multicast a message M, then it will eventually deliver M. Okay. Next, third one, agreement. If a correct process delivers the message M, then all other correct processes in the group M, group of messages, will eventually deliver the messages. The primitives here is R underscore multicast and deliver. Here the multicasting and deliver is important here. Next, coming to the implementation, first we need to initialize the message is received. The correct algorithm, but inefficient, each message is sent in the group times to each process. See, R multicast of G, M by P. Here, B multicast of G, M, where the process P belongs to G. Here, the B deliver M by Q with G equal to group of M. If M does not belong to the message is received, then the message received is equal to the message received. If Q not equal to P, then B multicast of G, M. Finally, R deliver of M. Here, last one is ordered multicast. Here in the ordered multicast, we are having some categories of ordering, that is FIFO ordering, and second one is casual ordering, the third one is total ordering. First one is FIFO ordering. FIFO means the first in, first out. If a current process issues a multicast of G, M, you need to understand multicast of G, M. Just you remember this point. In the previous slides, I told you G, M means sends a message M to all members of the group. Just if current process issues a multicast, that means it sends a message to all members of the group, and then multicast G, M2, this is the second message. Then every correct process that delivers M2 will deliver M1 before M2. That means if a correct process will deliver M1 before M2, M1 before M2, in the diagram you are having three processes, process P1, P2, and P3. In the P3, see here, we are having M3 here, M2 here. What they are saying, their intention is, they need to, if a correct process that delivers M2 will deliver M1 before M2. This is the timeline. This is the overtime. See here, this is the M2. M2 means message M2, which is the process when process 1 will get message M2. Okay, previously it receives message M1. After that, it receives message M3. Okay, that is what they are saying. The M1 will deliver, M2 will deliver M1 before M2. Total ordering. The second ordering is total ordering. In the total ordering, if a correct process delivers a message M2 before it delivers M1, see, understand the point, students. If a correct process delivers a message M2 before it delivers M1, then any correct process that delivers M1 will deliver M2 before M1. Bit confusing, student, here. I'm repeating once again. In the see in the diagram, if a correct process delivers a message M2 before it delivers M1, that means M2 is delivered before M1 delivered, then any correct process that delivers M1, any other process delivers M1, will deliver M2 before M1. Okay? It will be applicable to the all other processes. Okay? That means M1 and M2. If any process delivered M2 before M1, if all other process needs to deliver M2, M1, or M2 before M1. Last one is casual ordering. In the casual ordering, if multicast of G, M1, that is the group, the message M1 is sent to the all members of the group, implies G of M3. That means multicast of G of M3. Then any correct process that delivers M3 will deliver M1 before M3. See here. If multicast of G, M1, that means for a group of members, the message M1 will be multicasted, implies multicast of G, M3. Then any correct process that delivers M3 will deliver M1 before M3. what they are saying here in the casual ordering, M1 should be delivered before M3. M1 should be delivered before M3. See, for each process, observe, M1 should be delivered before M3. Okay, this is about the coordination and agreement. In tomorrow's class, I will start the next topic. That's it for today's students. Thank you.